Hello friends, how are you? So I thought I would share a beautiful tip on the power of asking. Today actually I had a patient for whom I did an implant before the lockdown, and the patient was supposed to give me 50,000 rupees for my as a balance. So today I told him, sir, we have got some difficulty because of this corona lockdown. Our clinic was not functional for the last 2 months, and also we have some commitments to pay for our overheads. So I told him, sir, would you don't mind me asking you your balance 50,000 rupees? And that guy paid the 50,000 rupees yesterday. It happened yesterday, and he paid me the 50,000 rupees without any reluctance. But before I asked for the money, there were a lot of thought process in my mind, like whether this guy will agree, or will he say that he will do it only after he will pay only after the work is done. And I also watch a lot of my friends. They are very reluctant to ask tell their owners, house owners, or the dealers, or the lab people about. They are very reluctant to ask for the help from the difficult situation. Like, for example, I am presently on a full mouth implant case which was pending. During the corona lockdown, it got pending, and I called them and I told them that we initially were spoken on an agreement for a particular amount for the lab work. The lab is actually in Bombay, so I requested them. I told them because of the lockdown, I have few difficulties. Can you please consider my request for some rate revision? Can we revise the rate because of the present situation? And they initially, without any reluctance, they said, definitely we will consider your difficulty and we will try to do some help for you. Dear friend, this is what is called the power of asking. I just want to tell you, this is the time asking. The ask principle will be very, very helpful, because if you are thinking that what will happen if I ask, whether they will be helping me, asking confidently, you know, there are three things you have to understand. The first thing is, you have to ask with a positive expectation. You should not feel negative about your asking. You should have a 100% confidence. Okay, yesterday I had a patient. Again, I want to tell you a second example of power of asking. Yesterday, one of my patient was having severe pain, and in the night time he came with the severe pain on his left side. So he was a banker. He was a banker and he was working in the bank. And he said, sir, I have severe pain. And we took an x-ray and we found that there is a crack. There is a crack in the tooth. So we told, there is nothing we can do. We can extract your teeth and try to help you to get rid of the pain. I told you, why don't you come tomorrow? We'll give an appointment to you and we will solve your problem. Then the patient was not very comfortable. So immediately I used the ask principle. I told him, sir, what is the expectation you have from me? Tell me today. I asked him very openly, what is your expectation from me today? He said, sir, please remove this teeth. This is why I came for. Then I told, okay, it is a 2-7 tooth, left upper 7 tooth. And the patient, while I extract, I told him it will fracture and it will take time. And I might charge you that based on the timings, I might charge you from say 1,000 to 2,000 rupees. And the patient said, money is not a problem for me, sir. Please get rid of me from this pain, because I have to go to the bank again tomorrow. He said he's working in Indian bank as a senior manager. So I told him, okay, sir. So I cleared everything by asking. So we charged him around 2,000 to 2,500 rupees for an extraction, and patient happily paid. He was not even bothering to pay, because his intention is to get rid of the teeth at somehow. And we asked all these questions in advance. So dear friends, there is no weakness in asking. First of all, asking lot of people think asking is a sign of weakness. Asking is a sign of strength. There is no weakness in asking. You try anything. This is the time a lot of people are trying to help others. I'm telling you, there are a lot of people who asked me for help during this quarantine period, and I helped them. Likewise, when you help others, you also will be helped. The first thing you are not believing in asking is because you have not done it before. So kindly ask help from the situation. If you are having a even lab people, you can ask the dealers, you can ask the house owners, you can ask anybody. Even your staffs also, you have to ask, you know, can I pay you 50% salary and can I pay you later? They will definitely agree. You know, asking is a sign of strength and it is not a sign of weakness. And if you are waiting that someone will come and give you what you want, the chances are we might never get it. All you have to do is always you have to try to ask what you want in life. That is why if you see a child which is born will always ask for milk, ask for food. The world runs like this. The Bible also says, ask and it will be given unto you, seek and you will be finding it, and knock and the doors will be open. So it is a law. You have to ask. Asking is not a sign of weakness and asking is a sign of strength. There are very few people who ask help from others, who ask guidance from others. Today, if you happen to see your life also and my life also, there are many things we have not got it because we have not asked it. We could have asked our seniors how to do it. You go and ask some successful person, sir, how you are so successful in life? Can you please tell me? There is no, don't give assumptions. We always assume things. Okay, he's having a political background, that is why he is successful. He's having this background, that is why he is successful. We always assume like that. So kindly don't assume things like that. Rather verify with those people and ask them. So asking is very good principle which will help you to earn money. And also one thing I want to tell you is very important practice management tool is, if you are still watching the video, I want to tell you, today in this time when patients are entering your clinic, the first thing is you have to ask him is, what is the purpose of your visit? He might say, sir, I have just come to take medication, I have just come to take treatment. And once you ask this question in advance, then you can plan your consulting accordingly, or you will be keep on talking. See, talking is different from asking. You know, talking the animals only do, you know, bow bow, the dog bow bows, the cat says meow meow. Cat doesn't ask, dog doesn't ask, but human beings can ask. Okay, what is your purpose of this visit? What do you want me to do? So please ask. Ask is a very powerful tool, and I hope I have added some value. If you are very impressed with this video, if you find this video is useful, please comment and please also share this video. And keep watching more of such videos to make you understand the concepts. Asking is very powerful. Ask questions, ask for help, and ask for the right things, and you will get it. I promise you. Thank you, and God bless you. Have a great week, or have a great day ahead. Thank you, and God bless you.